Today we're talking about manipulating strings in Perl. Dynamic languages often provide specialized types, operators, and/or functions that make string manipulation tasks easier, and Perl is no exception. Strings in Perl are scalar values, and we need to quote all strings that we use. We can use single quotes, or we can use double quotes. There are also quote-like operators that serve a similar purpose. Q is similar to single quotes, and QQ is similar to double quotes. The quote-like operators allow us to use other delimiters, like braces here, to make our code clearer. So, what's the difference between these single-quoted or Q-quoted strings, or these double-quoted or QQ-quoted strings? Well, somewhat like the Born shell, single-quoted or Q-quoted strings are not interpolated, but double-quoted strings or QQ-quoted strings are. You'll need to escape with backslashes the dollar, at, and percent sigils if you want them to appear literally in an interpolated string. Perl's interpolation rules are very friendly, allowing us to subscript arrays or hashes inline, but it's probably best to be sparing in doing so, as this can make your code harder to read. One curious gotcha is that single quotes are a valid part of a variable name, which can have unintended effects when interpolating. If we want to concatenate strings, we can use the dot operator. Watch out for this, because many other languages choose to overload the plus operator. As with other binary operators in Perl, I can also dot assign to concatenate onto an existing variable. In other languages, the same comparison operators can compare numbers and strings. In Perl, though, there are separate operators to do a numeric comparison, that is, to compare numeric values, and lexicographic comparison, that is, to compare dictionary order of words. If I compare two strings using the numeric equality operator, I get a warning, because instead I should use the string equality operator EQ. And there are analogues for the whole range of comparison operators. Our less than becomes LT, less equal, of course, becomes LE, greater than becomes GT, and greater equal becomes GE. There's also a general comparison operator, the rocket ship operator, which returns 0 if the values are equal, less than 0 if the value is less, or greater than 0 if the value is more, like Sturkamp in C. Again, this only works on numeric values. To compare strings, we'd use CMP. Perl lets us interact with the system, which makes it invaluable for system administration tasks. One useful feature is that I can run a command and capture its output using backticks, or the QX operator. I could, for example, use date, which gives us the system's idea of the date and time. In backticks, this yields a string value, which we can then manipulate further by other means. New lines in the program's output are left intact in this string. I've written a simple subroutine, show s, which wraps quote delimiters around our string, so we can see where that new line is. I can use chomp to remove that trailing new line. It returns the number of characters it removed. To extract a portion of a string, I can use substr, which takes three arguments, a string, an offset, and a length, and extracts a substring from that zero indexed offset for that length of characters. If the offset is negative, it counts backwards from the end of the string. If we don't specify a length at all, it returns all the characters to the end of the string. And if we specify a negative length, it skips that many characters back from the end of the string. One of Perl's more curious features is expression evaluation, on-the-fly evaluation of strings as Perl. Eval is incredibly powerful and exceptionally dangerous, as you can allow arbitrary code execution in your code. Given Perl's capable built-in operations, it's easy for a malicious attacker to wreak untold havoc, so be careful. Most of the Perl you write won't be at an interactive prompt, either in this sort of read, evaluate, print loop, or REPL, or using Perl as a filter in the Bourne shell environment, but rather in standalone scripts. Sometimes you'll be writing Perl to deal with injecting particular text into some complex predefined template which you want to inline into your script, if you're generating web pages, for example. There's a few ways to do that. For example, strings in Perl can span multiple lines, however, that's not especially idiomatic Perl. More common is a mechanism called a hierdoc, which looks just like the Bourne shell. I have a pair of less than signs and an identifier, and everything from that identifier until that identifier appears again is captured with interpolation. By default, that interpolation happens. Single quoting the identifier name prevents that interpolation. I can also save a hierdoc value into a variable and use it again later. I can also mix this with other strings too. So here's what our whole program looks like to run. Lovely. And for better characterized coverage of these topics, check out the Perl documentation collection. And don't forget to check out our video on working with regular expressions in Perl.